The Commonwealth is a scary place, and that's why today Gameranx brings you the top 10 creepiest locations in Fallout 4. Number 10, Hope's March Pentecostal Church. So out in the glowing sea, everything sucks, basically. It's all irradiated, you can hardly do anything, except for there's a bunch of, like, mutants and stuff out there as well, who can handle that stuff. Now, basically, as a rule, abandoned churches are creepy anyway, so what about if the buildings fall apart, and they're inhabited by a massive amount of basically zombie-looking dudes? It's not a nice place to be. Number 9, Federal Surveillance Center K-21B. It's creepy because the entrance is a shack. You go in and you see a skeleton that didn't quite make it down the hatch. But it's not like it really mattered a whole lot anyway, because you go in and you find, oh hey, another skeleton. I don't know whether it was radiation or they just sat in their desk till they died. I'd put my money on radiation. But it's a grisly scene. In fact, throughout the entire complex, it's essentially just an empty, lifeless building with skeletons and surveillance equipment. Both creepy and, if you think about it, rather sad. Number 8, the Museum of Witchcraft. The fun thing about this place is when you first get there, you have to follow a trail of dead bodies from the basement to the upper floor. And it's not like you did it for fun either. There's a death claw up at the top and you have to fight them. It functioned as a jump scare for me, I don't know about you. But then once that was done, there's some really enjoyable displays of mannequins. And they're depicting the events of the Salem witch trials. Oh, and they're horrifying. I don't know, psychological terror, much worse than jump scares. But either way, the Museum of Witchcraft has both. For me anyway. Number 7, Pickman Gallery. Okay, so basically this is a place where a serial killer who considered himself an artist dismembered raiders and made art with it. Frankly, it's just grotesque. The paintings on the wall were made in the blood of his victims. And you know, there's body parts and stuff all over. Nice big pile of flesh. I was actually terrified here. Pickman's down in the basement and he's about to get killed by a bunch of revenge-oriented fellows. People don't really like the type of thing that he's doing there. And if you do save him, he gives you a key to a safe. And inside that safe is Pickman's blade, which is a nice melee weapon with some enhanced stealth and bleeding effects. Number 6, the General Atomics Galleria. There's not so much of a creepy atmosphere here so much as there is robots all over the place that literally need very little provocation to kill you. The contrast of these cold-blooded killers with the sort of domestic look of the area kind of gives it a weird dystopian feel, especially since it's all run down and, you know, there was a nuclear explosion. There's also a really weird backstory for the area, but I won't go into that because I'd rather have you experience it yourself. Number 5, Dunwich Borers. So on the outside, it really just kind of looks like a mining pit, which, not a big deal. But if you get to the bottom of the place, and I mean literally go to the bottom of the place, you'll find that this is a horrific location. If you read all the terminals, you find that there was a group of pre-war employees there that met kind of a not great fate. And stuff like the buried skeletons in the wall and the hallucinations kind of, you know, enhance that feeling of dread that you have as you go down to the bottom. But hey, there's a pretty powerful sacrificial blade at the bottom of a pool of water in it, if you can tolerate the creepy. It's called Krem's Tooth, and this is where you get it, so enjoy those hallucinations. Number 4, Hallucigen Inc. What do you get when you cross a weapons manufacturer with the US military and stir in a little bit of corruption? You get this place. The company's goals included militarized crowd control, weapons manufacturing, and volatile chemicals. Basically, all that's left of the place is a bunch of paranoid ranting raiders, but I don't know what they went through. I don't. Number 3, Parsons State Insane Asylum. So this is probably actually one of the prettier looking places. I mean, pretty in like a horrific sort of way, obviously, but pretty. It might seem a little bit cliche because, I don't know, you've seen the creepy asylum in about 400 other games, movies, and everything. But I don't know, maybe you like H.P. Lovecraft a little bit, because that's kind of the direction the story goes in inside. That's about all I can say without getting spoilery. And I understand the game's been out a while, but it's not the same as going to see Force Awakens. That's 2 hours of your life. You could easily spend 2 hours in the Parsons State Sane Asylum if you wanted, or more. Number 2, the Chinese Submarine. Actually, not even far off the coast. There's a Chinese submarine with a bunch of ghouls in it that have been hanging around for about 200 years. Now, you might be able to put two and two together and figure out why there was a Chinese submarine around, but I still won't spoil. There's an interesting story to be told on here, and it does involve the end of the world. Finally, Fenn Street Sewer. Just outside Diamond City, there's a dude trying to give Pickman, you know, that serial killer who's an artist, a run for his money. But this guy considers himself an artist as well, but rather than the painting thing, this guy liked to pose his victims in a demeaning, sadistic fashion, and he goes by the name the Fenn's Phantom. Now, there's a few different areas where the Phantom clearly played with his victims, including one that clues you in on the idea that he may have kidnapped and killed several young women and their babies. This is by far the creepiest place you can go in the game. I mean, by most normal standards, some people find the Institute to be pretty damn creepy. But if you were thinking about how creeped out you would be in real life if you came across something like this, by far, just the most horrific. What do you think is the most creepy place in the game? Well, I'd like to hear from you in the comments. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please click the like button. And if you're not subscribed to us, now's a great time to do so because we upload brand new videos every single day of the week. Best way to see them first? Yep, a subscription. As always, we thank you very much for watching this video. And we will see you again next time here on Gameranx.